Hello! In this video, we're going to talk about how to do a voiceover PowerPoint. And we're going to specify that it be PowerPoint. Google Slides, if you wanted to do a voiceover Google Slide, you've got to do a couple other add-ons and mesh it all together. It's a lot easier if, even if you have your Google Slide, it's just take your Google Slide, convert it to a PowerPoint, open this up in PowerPoint. PowerPoint has all the tools built right in, so that's going to make your life a lot easier. Okay. So let's get started on this. Okay, so let's say you want to do a voiceover PowerPoint. You've already created your PowerPoint. Make sure your PowerPoint's created, all your animations are done, and that you've run through it once or twice. Then you make sure that it's good, okay? Now, Microsoft has a lot of tools already built in. So let me show you how to do a voiceover. What you want to do is you want to go up top here to where it says slideshow. Okay, and that's right underneath that button is the record slideshow button. Okay. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to click that. There we go. Notice as soon as I do that, that a video pops up here in the right hand corner. That's a video obviously of me doing this presentation. If you do not like the video and you do not want to have yourself be on video, that's fine. All you have to do is click this little button right underneath it. It looks like a video camera. You click that will turn it off. Now your video is no longer there. Although I will tell you, it really brings a lot to the students when they can see you. It's more engaging if you can. So I would highly recommend that you do a video. We'll talk about the sizing. You can make it bigger or smaller. We'll talk about that kind of on the back end. But okay, so I recommend that you do that. This is just your microphone. If you want your microphone, you're going to need your microphone, so make sure you don't turn that off and make sure to keep it on. Okay. Now, I'm still not recording at this point, so what I need to do in order to record is I need to hit this button right up top here. This is record. Okay, that's going to make it really, really easy. Microsoft's made it nice for us, okay? So we're going to click this record button, and you'll see that the countdown occurs. And as soon as the countdown is over, and then now we are recording our video. And you can say, welcome. This is the first screencast that we're doing. We're walking through this together. Now, you can advance the slide, rewind the slide, do all those other things just like you normally would, right? You can go up to your computer and you can hit the button. And this brings up the slide. That's absolutely great if you wanted to use a PowerPoint clicker so that you're not reaching over and clicking that button and hearing that sound in the background, you can. I can use this just the same. I can go forward, I can go backward. Any of those are just fine, okay? So, but what I, either way, it doesn't really matter, just so long as you can have access to advance your slides. Okay. Another cool thing that I want to show you here is down here on the bottom, we've got erasers, we've got pens. If you wanted to, you could write right on top of here. Now, it's very difficult, for those of you who have never done this, it's very difficult to write with a mouse. I really struggle with that, so for me, I would not do that. But maybe you are more talented in that area, so you might want to do it, but that's fine. Okay, so the next thing is I'm still just advancing forward through these slides. Couple things. Number one, when you do a voiceover PowerPoint, is you need to be personable. People really like that, right? You want to show a little passion for it. You don't want to talk at a monotone for 5 minutes. They will quickly turn your video off. Okay, instead, hopefully this is something that you're passionate about. So show that. Just be normal, right? In front of the classroom, you're very passionate, so just do the same thing. Okay. So you want to explain it all. You want to run through your PowerPoint beforehand, because if you don't run through your PowerPoint, there are going to be some errors that come along that you're not going to catch. So, and you hate to get, 5 minutes into a video and then have to go back through and redo it. But that's okay. It's not the end of the world if you do. But okay, when you're done, let's say that I'm done. Okay, this is the end of my video that I want to do on my voiceover PowerPoint. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right up here to the stop button. Like I say, Microsoft has made this really, really easy. We hit the stop button. There we go. It is stopping my recording right now. Okay, now that my recording has stopped, I can exit out of here, okay? You can just advance like you normally would and you'll exit out. Done. And you'll see now on my PowerPoints that weren't here before, but I have my little picture down here, okay? And so that's the first indication that you've successfully recorded this. Now, you can get on here, and let's say on this second one, I don't like my picture here because it's maybe covering up some words. So instead, I want to move my picture. So just click it and move it. When I'm on that slide, let's say I want to make it bigger. No problem. Make it bigger. That way, when you're on that slide, it will automatically go to that location. That's a wonderful part of it. And you can kind of see as you go through your slides how much room you have. Like on this one, I'm like, okay, I can make this a little bit bigger. And you don't want your video to be too small But you're not the focus of this lesson, right? So you want it to at least be engaging, but not the main focus. So somewhere in between there, somewhere about this size is what I'm told works best. So, okay, so now you've compiled all this together. If you wanted to, you could go through all of this. Now, what we're going to do now is we need to package that in a video format so that we can share it to our Google Classroom or share it to YouTube. So what we're going to do is we go over to File, and on this file, we're going to Export. And here we go, we're gonna create a video. Okay, now, when you create a video, you get to choose, if you wanted it in 4K because you want that perfect picture on it, you could do that. It just takes a little bit longer to process. For right now, I'm just gonna use 1080p, that will be just fine. So I'm gonna go in right here and I'm going to create this video. And we need to name it something, and I need to determine where it's going to be. So on this one, I'm just gonna put it on my desktop right here. And I'm going to name this on my first screencast. Sounds great, love it. You might name it chapter 2 or chapter 3 or whatever you wanted to do there, but you're going to save it. It's going to take some time to process this, okay? So I'm going to get on there and I'm going to process it. Once it's done processing, I'm going to show you what it looks like, okay? So I'll take a break right now and go to that one, let it process, and then I'll come right back on to you. Okay, it looks like my video is done being processed. It took about 3 or 4 minutes to process that one with our Wi-Fi here. Let me go in, let me open that one up now. I saved it to my desktop, so let me open up my desktop. Here we go. First screencast. I should be able to open this, play
and
this.
As soon as the countdown is over, and then now we are recording our video. And you can say, welcome. This is
And you get the opportunity to watch the whole thing. Now, let me just fast forward just a little bit. You see how it changed?
Right on top of here. Now, it's very difficult.
I'm going to push pause on this. You see how it changed the location of my video right here. Everything else stay there, just change the location. Now, I have a green screen, of course, on my background, and you can change yours. You'll probably want to have something that looks a little bit better than my green screen here, but in your classroom is probably just fine. So anyway, once you've got that, now that we've got that, we can share this out. I'm going to make it out of here. Right, it's in your folders. So I can share this out. I'm on my desktop right here. And let's move this, there we go. And I can share this to my Google Classroom. I can upload it to YouTube. We can do any of those same things with it. So anyway, so this is, hopefully you found this to be useful. If you do have any questions, please let me know. I'm happy to help wherever I can.